Hello everyone! In this video, I'm going to show you how to make a virtual classroom using bitmoji for remote learning. First of all, I have to admit that I'm not a tech savvy at all. Actually, I haven't imagined myself teaching online ever. However, due to COVID-19 break, we are facing a new era, an emergency school closure. Since then, I've tried real hard to figure out how I can manage this remote class. It took me a while, but now I really enjoy making online classes and communicate with my students online. If you like this tips that I share in this video, you can show your support by clicking on the like button or sharing with your other teachers that you know and subscribing to my channel. I like to share lots of educational sites and programs that teachers can use. So please hit the notification bell to make sure you don't miss my updates. Okay, today I want to share this amazing idea about making virtual classroom using bitmoji. When I saw this first time, I was like, wow, it looks really amazing. So I hope you enjoy this and find my video useful for your remote class too. So here is the table about what we'll cover for today. Let me walk you through from the very start. First of all, you have to install bitmoji app on your mobile phone. You cannot install this app on your computer. Once you get it from Google Play Store or App Store on your mobile phone, you can install that bitmoji extension for your computer. Okay, let me show you how to do this. Okay. So here it is. After you install bitmoji app on your phone, you can search bitmoji Chrome. Then here, because I already installed this bitmoji extension, there it says remove from Chrome. But if you click this one, that will say that add to Chrome. So click this blue button here. Okay, then go back. And there are 9 dots here. It shows you the menu options that Google offers. So Google Slides, you can choose Google Slides here. Google Slides, I think, is one of the cool things that Google offers. I find out it's really useful since my school is using Google Slides for the remote learning system. And it is similar to PowerPoint program, but simpler. But it works beautifully, especially if you use Google Classroom or Google Sites. So let's see. Oh, this is the lesson I made for my students. Since I am an EFL teacher, I made a lesson about asking and answering the prices of the items here, and then I made the virtual shoe stores to practice the expressions. So this is this audio button. So click this.
Welcome to Happy Shoe Store.
And so you can listen to what character says, which is my emoji, bitmoji. Okay. So, I use that read and write Google extension. Then I will talk about that add-on later in my other video. I think the wonderful thing about this Google Slides is that it gives opportunities to students to be a part of the lesson. It is more interactive than just watching the video, right? And also, right, you can see here, they can practice asking and answering the key expressions here. Okay, let me see. So if you want to make a virtual classroom using this Google Slides, add a new slide here and just remove this text box to make it neat. Then I will add it from here. Then I want to set up the background, the floor and the wall. So click the insert and image, search the web and floor and wall, type in, and I'll choose this and just drag and drop onto the slide. You can resize this image to fit into the slide, see? And I want to answer at dusk, right? So dusk. And you should be transparent because the background, they already added on. So drag and drop. It's too big, so I make it smaller. And also, you can flip it. The format options on the top bar, and here size and rotation, flip it, right? See? Okay. Then I want to add a nice and cozy couch that I can sit on it. Okay, see, then Google, you can add an image from the Google search. So couch transparent, right? Oh, I like this one. So, oh, I want to add this one here. So drag and drop. No, it's not transparent. It tricked me. Oh, it happens all the time. Then I have a tip for you. So you go to the website remove.bz here and drag. Oh, no. Drag and drop the image to right here. Oh no. Let me show you how to do this. Okay. From the couch. So drag and drop the image here. Then it is working to get rid of the background. So download it, then okay. Remove this one, and I will add a new one. Upload from computer since I downloaded it. Open it. See, there's no background. Then I can add up here. If it is too small, then just resize it. Then it's time to add my bitmoji to the slide. So click on this little green face. Right? Yes. Since I want to sit on the couch, then I can add up here. But if you wanna look for another various poses, then you can type in pose and there are lots of options that you can choose. So sitting bitmoji here, sit, I want to sit on the couch, this cozy couch here. Okay, I will sit here thinking, right? Then I want to add TV here because I want to show a video clip that I made to the students, right? So TV transparent. See, I like this one. Okay, this drag and drop and resize it. Okay, then let's see. I made this video for my students before, so just copy the link here and insert video and paste the link here and select. You can see the little bit of the preview of the video, the resize it and make it fit into my TV on the desk. Okay, and also there's a good thing about this, you can choose when to start and when to end, and also there are no ads when you show the video from through this Google Slides. I think it's really beneficial for the students because there are some not appropriate inappropriate ads for the students on the YouTube videos. Okay, so I want to insert some image of notebook because I want my students to solve the quiz. Okay, let me see. What it means. Oh, I like this one. And I made this the quiz for the students. Link, copy the link, and there is a link button here. Click on it and paste the link and apply. And I want students, I don't want to get lost, so call out. So add some direct explanation for them. Text box here. Watching the video. Click the notebook to solve the quiz. So there is an explanation for the students here. Okay, then I think I've done my part. Oh, okay, there is another thing that I want to show you. Okay, so there is a transition effect. So when you move on to the next slide, you can add some effect. Like there is some here, you can choose from here, the cube, then play. So it will move on to the next slide like this way. Okay, so the lastly, I want to show you how to share this with students. There is a share button on the top bar here, and click it and copy the link here. If you are using the Google Classroom, you can paste and the link and post it. Since I'm using Google Sites, I can embed this link to my Google Sites like this. Insert and resize it like this. So let's see how things will work out on students' end. As you see, students can watch this video just fine here. And don't worry if this screen is too small, then you can click this button and it will go on full screen. And if you click this notebook, this will take the students to the quiz that I made. And oh, not this one. Yes, here. Okay, click on this arrow, then it will go on to the next slide like this way.
Okay, and then welcome to Happy Shoes Store. May I help you? Do you want new shoe?
Like this way. Okay, that's it. That is for today's video. Thank you so much for watching my video to the end. If you found the tips that I shared helpful, please share it with your other teachers and subscribe to my channel. Have a nice day.